When the cafe doors exploded, I reacted to you. Cast a tap that sunny morning, I was coming to, but now I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you.
It's been like 2 years since our last record came out, but we've also been on tour most of the time, and I don't really write on the road, and we'll be making a new record that'll hopefully be done by the spring, out by the late summer, early fall. It's kind of very natural to me at the very beginning of the process to be thinking about and writing about political issues. I played a show in DC on the night of President Obama's inauguration, and I made a very simple statement from stage, which was just, I'm really glad that we've achieved this. Just remember that we have to, you know, hold this new administration's feet to the fire. And I got booed. And that, you know, that said a lot to me about my worst fears about the political climate on both sides of the aisle in the United States. This is what the Occupy thing is all about. When we were on tour in the fall, I reached out to, you know, just via Twitter, just saying like, hey, if you're occupying in your town and you see that we're coming to it, let me know. And I was able to come down and play some music at a few of them, and you know, it was great, just connect with people. Wisdom to the shelf. Punk rock, from my, you know, 25, 30 years of experience with it, in a lot of the most fundamental ways, it hasn't really changed that much. And what I mean by that is that there is always an underground, there's always a deeper underground. There are always, you know, bands that break through despite themselves, and there are always bands that break through because, as punk as they may be, they go for it in a rock star way, you know? Like, we're not rock stars. So I still retain like such great sympathy for what it's like to be a struggling band starting out. I don't envy anyone starting out right now, but dear God, do I admire them.